And joining us now on Hot Copy, we have with us Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman. Good morning to you, ma'am.
Good morning, Ms. Karen, and good morning po sa lahat ng viewers natin.
All right, before we start, I'd like to say that Secretary Mina was confirmed by the Commission on Appointments last week. And it's interesting to note that you are the only woman member of the economic team and the only Muslim in the cabinet. So I'd have to say, not enough. But then again, congratulations. So what are your thoughts on that?
Thank you so much, Ms. Karen. Of course, I'm overwhelmed, no? Dahil po, I think this Congress, before they went into recess, they only confirmed 11 cabinet members, I think. So I was lucky enough to be part of that first batch of those who were confirmed during before the recess.
All right. So let's get down to business. Some good news first coming from the Budget Department. Just the other day, you approved the release of 1.04 billion pesos in additional funds to cover the special risk allowance of health workers for COVID response. So let's talk about that. Where did you get the funds for this? Was this part of what we call the unused funds, savings in governments? San po ito nanggaling, Secretary?
Yung the 1.4 billion that we released, and together with the 11.8 billion that we released this week, both were able to get it from our miscellaneous personal benefits fund.
Okay.
And unprogrammed appropriations and the contingent fund.
Oh, so kumbaga you consolidated funds from different sources, is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. May mapagkukunan pa ba? Because I know this 1 billion will only cover something like 55,000 health workers with 5,000 a month during the COVID pandemic. Pero alam po natin that I think there's 73 billion pesos in overdue allowances that's mandated under the law, right, during the COVID response.
I think what I heard po is that 64 billion po yung kailangan ng ating health workers, no, para po mabayaran yung mga allowances po nila.
Uh-oh.
But then as of now po kasi this is what we release are the only the requests that we have gotten from the Department of Health. We don't have the request yet from the Department of Health, yung 64 billion po na sinasabi nila.
Okay, so what you're trying to say is it's the requests coming from the DOH. If they request more, may mapagkukunan pa po ba, Secretary?
As of now po, parang medyo negative na po tayo sa ating mga balanse. But we will try po. Kasi if we will try to get from our unprogrammed appropriations, mm-hmm. I think I will have to check po with the DOF and our Treasury if there are ano po, additional revenues po from the national government.
Okay.
So maybe if we will have po, we will try to allocate funding po.
Oo. So yan po pinag-uusapan natin, ang pinagkukunan is from the existing 2022 budget. Let's move now to some of the alarm bells being raised in the 2023 budget that's been submitted to Congress. You have advocates saying that in 2023, only 19 billion pesos was allotted for the special risk allowances for health workers that would only amount to 3 months of the back wages. Tama po ba ito, Secretary? Are there still funds allotted for COVID-19 benefits for 2023?
For 2023 po, what we have is under unprogrammed appropriations, we also appropriated another 38.9 billion po for the purpose.
Oo. Pero itong 38 billion, the appropriation, is it under unprogrammed funds or it's under the DOH?
It's under unprogrammed funds po, unprogrammed appropriations po.
So this is the issue of health workers. Benefits that are mandated, that they deserve, that's been set aside under the law. Bakit sila pa daw po ang naka-unprogrammed funds?
We have to consider po what's happening right now po. While we want po to provide funds for everyone, as a result din po of the pandemic, so lower revenues po. The increase of our budget for 2023 is only 4.9%. In practical terms po, that's only a little over 200 billion, almost 300 billion po. We try po to increase the budget of all the departments as we can po. But really, the budget provided for us is really, really small.
Okay.
We receive po a total of, actually po, if I may po, we receive a total of 8 trillion projects po and budget po for 2023.
Okay. So you received a total of 8 trillion in projects in which the Department of Budget, along with the Department of Finance, essentially whittled it down to more than 5 trillion.
Yes. Our budget, our proposed budget po is only 5.268 trillion.
Uh-oh. Okay. All right. Now, one of the controversial aspects of already what we call a limited budget right now, even if there's been an increase, is, I'd have to bring this up, is Congressman Ed Selagman, rightly so, brought up what he called unnecessary and excessive confidential and intelligence funds. So there's over $9 billion of confidential and intelligence funds in the 2023 budget. So ang tanong dito, while it's undergoing scrutiny in the Senate right now, bakit pumasa sa budget department, $500 million for the Office of the Vice President, $150 million tucked in for surveillance funds in the DepEd? People have been asking, why would that even be presented by the budget secretary?
When they presented po the budget, when we prepared the budget po, one of the things that we consider po is whether they can really use the money and if they have plans for the money. So when they presented their budget po, we deem po that the budget given to them is will be used po for proper use po. They have indicated the programs kung saan po nila gagamitin yung mga Intel funds. And of course po, ito pong mga Intel funds na to,
But you were not alarmed, Secretary Amena, that the Department of Education in its history, according to Senator Coco Pimentel and Senator Pia Cayetano, has never had a confidential and Intel funds. They've never come across it. This is the first time it's requested.
I'm not sure po if I can if I can divulge po, but during the cabinet po, it was also discussed po na detalye po ng ating mahal na Vice Presidente kung saan po gagamitin itong mga tinatawag na Intel and confidential funds. So during that time, parang everyone from the cabinet naman po agreed on it. So we approve po the request of the Vice President.
Okay, so you're saying it was more of a cabinet decision that has agreed to this request. And I know that, to be fair to you, Congress will be realigning some funds, right? So ang tanong ng ilan dito nga is, isn't this such a politicized budget? Some have said there have been so many agencies na tinanggalan ng pondo pero pinagbigyan ang confidential at intelligence funds ng OVP, ng DepEd, and more than that, even the presidential confidential funds is still at $5 billion, which to be fair has increased through the years, right? Pero don't you think this is such a politicized budget?
Ay, hindi naman po siguro. Actually, when we prepared the budget po, actually pagdating po namin, we already have the budget. But what we tried to do is ask the new cabinet members to prepare and look at the budgets what we have, because we were given only a short time during the transition po to prepare the budget, and we have a mandated, the constitution says that we have to submit the budget before the, 60 days yata after the opening of Congress. So it was discussed by the cabinet po, the proposed budget, and then sorry lang po, I cannot give the details of kung saan po gagamitin yung mga confidential Intel funds. But definitely po, meron po mga programa na associated po doon sa Intel funds that we provided.
Uh-oh. And I heard item po ba, Budget Secretary, ang paggamit nito?
Ang budget po is, it's a line item, but it's lump sum in nature. But then in 2015 po, nagkaroon po ng circular guidelines ang DBM and POA, I think po, nilagyan po natin ng at least kahit papano po ng mga regulation po on how to use it. While it is lump sum in nature, before you can use it po, you have to submit sa COA po kung ano po yung nature ng mga projects or programs na paggagamitan ng Intel funds.
And Secretary, what makes this lump sum appropriation different from what the Supreme Court has decided upon, that it prohibits lump sum appropriations?
Ito po kasi, even if it's lump sum, meron, yun po yung sinasabi po natin, na meron po at least, meron pa rin po mga guidelines na kailangan nating ilabas once the budget has been approved.
Okay, all right. Because Senator Pimentel pointed out something quite interesting also in the DPWH budget. But he noted some unspecified allotments. He says some parts of the budget lack detail, no line items. And overall, there were parts that lack transparency. What's your reaction to this?
I think hindi po siguro, because for example, like sa DPWH, there meron po silang mga major programs on how they will use the budget, and they have several breakdowns po on how they will allocate their budgeting.
Okay. Now, Secretary, my sources, no, at the intelligence agency are even in shock that the budget being requested by the DepEd for intelligence is 9 billion pesos higher than theirs. And that's the intelligence agency of the government. I mean, coming from the executive, why would this kind of a budget be drafted?
Again po, as I will ano po, well, when presented to us po during the budget deliberations in DBM, and at the same time when we discuss it together with the cabinet and the president po, when our vice president po and secretary of education presented po the CONFI and Intel funds, there were may details po ito on how they will use it, and the secretary po and the vice president indicated bakit po kailangan lagyan to ng pondo.
Pero naniniwala po ba tayo, kayo, na mas kailangan ng DepEd ng Intel funds kesa mismong sa Intel Agency ng Pilipinas?
Siguro po siya po yung secretary po ng budget ng DepEd and the vice president. I think meron po siyang mga programa na gustong i-prioritize at kailangan tutukan. And he needs some probably a little elbow room to be able to implement those projects and come up with a program po.
All right. Now some educators are quite shocked that with these Intel funds in the DepEd, and then there is no money for SPED, although I know the latest is the lower house has already realigned I think 500 million only for special 500 million for special education. That's correct. Pero tama po ba ang sinabi po kasi ng DepEd in several interviews is they've actually proposed a 532 budget for SPED, but it was the DBM that scrapped it. Is that correct, Secretary?
Ms. Karen, we did not actually scrap it. When we prepared the budget po, we take into consideration a lot of factors. And first and foremost po is the utilization po of the budget. If hindi po ito nagagamit, and plus the fact po that the 2022 budget that was passed last year will can still be used until 2023, I think they have enough funds. So for SPED po, the obligation rate that we have right now is only 1.13%, or they have only spent 6.35 million out of the 560 million allocation they have. So I think given nga po that the budget is quite really limited given the tight monetary pressures that we have, no? So siguro po pwede po natin ilagay sa mga ibang programs and projects po of DepEd dahil meron pa po silang natitirang pondo.
So to be fair to the executive, especially the Department of Budget and Management, the bigger issue is they're asking for money, hindi naman nagagamit. Hindi nila alam gamitin.
Yes.
And a lot of the, go ahead, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. A lot of I think it's human nature, no? Kahit po nasa bahay natin, I think kahit yung mga bata, anak, or pamangkin, pag humingi po ng pera, it's always sobra po, no? But really, in a tight fiscal space po, I think it's really difficult to, I mean, provide pag hindi mo po magagastos yung pera. That's why we've been pushing po for the, at least yung transition natin for cash budgeting system. We only want to fund projects and programs that are shovel ready po. Yung tama po, meron na pong implementation.
Oo. Because when you read articles about it, when it comes out in the media, it looks really bad. But have you ever, I think, as not you personally, but have agencies met? And because clearly there's making the budget, but there's also the problem of using it and disbursement. How will that be better under the Marcos administration? Because I'm sure the president would want changes in this system.
If I may cite po, I think one of the issues that was raised po is that the DepEd po, yung project nila for the school buildings was reduced. But what we did po kasi is that, again, the utilization is quite low. So, kaya po siya nabawasan. So, they have enough funding. So, what we're trying to do now is actually last week, we met with, we met with VP Sara, NEDA Secretary R.C. Balisakan, Secretary Manny Bonoan, and Secretary Jokno. We asked them to prepare po a plan, a six-year, 10-year plan of an inventory of all classrooms po na kailangan i-rehabilitate and to construct. Given a 6-period time or even kahit po 10 years. And then we can allocate better and then ensure that when we put funding, yearly funding, it's being implemented.
Mm-mm. So is it a secretary, an absorptive capacity issue? Or frankly speaking, is it an issue of mabagal lang talaga sa gobyerno? Ano pang issue po natin? At yung ating mga kapitbahay sa Asia, sa totoo lang, right? I mean, they are building faster. We want to set aside the money. You want them to spend it. What's our problem, Secretary?
Some of the projects po siguro are not well-planned.
Okay.
For example nga po, kunyari, meron pong clinic or health barangay health center na pinopropose ang isang ahensya. When implementation period come, what happens is that yung site po nila, it's not suitable.
Mm-mm.
So kailangan po tayong bumalik ulit, or sometimes we cannot fund it at all. I mean, they cannot use the money po. It's practically po proper planning. That's why we are in touch always with the government procurement board to help also our practitioners, our budget practitioners, our leaders po sa mga department para po magkaroon ng proper planning and proper procurement plan po.
Yeah. Okay. Now, balikan po natin ang health, no? You have some hospital practitioners, health practitioners that were quite alarmed. Although I know the budget's being realigned right now, but the fact that it was submitted with the Lung Center, Philippine Children's Medical Center, Philippine Institute of Traditional and Alternative Health, the National Nutrition Council, all with budget cuts. Some have said this is a budget that actually didn't defend the poor, the sick, the unprivileged, even malnourished children. Secretary, paano po nauwi sa ganon na nabawasan po ang ilang mga ospital na ito?
If we will compare po with the 2022 GAA, definitely po you will see a reduction of the budget.
Uh-oh.
But if you will compare po with the NEP of 2022, meron po tayong increase. Yung mga increases po kasi ng 2022, if you compare it with GAA and NEP that we propose now, yung nasa 2022 po kasi, meron na po dito yung mga amendments or initiatives ng ating mga, na ating mga nasa legislature po.
Mm-mm. Okay. So, ang ibig sabihin po niyan, in layman's terms, kasi you explained it.
Technically po, wala po talagang
binawasan.
From our end po, bawas. Kasi when we compare po apples to apples, from NEP to NEP po.
Uh-oh.
But then, kasi po, we have to present it to Congress. So, sila po, minsan ang nag-a-adjust po. Kaya parang nakikita po natin yung malaking pagbaba po ng mga budget natin.
Oo. So, when it comes out, when it's printed, appears like there's been a decrease, pero ang sinasabi nyo, technically speaking, hindi nabawasan.
Yes po.
So just because, I mean, I don't do the budget, so I'm curious. How do you explain, like, the Lung Center of the Philippines? It states for 2023, 630 million. And in 2022, it was 684 million. So in budgeting terms, what does that mean? Someone would ask, where did the 50 million go?
Nagamit na po yung 50 million.
Yun.
Some of the congressional initiatives po ng ating mga legislature, these are one-time projects po. So pag nabili na po nila, hindi na po natin kailangan ponduhan for the next year.
That's interesting. So it doesn't mean tinanggalan yung
non-request
nila, nagamit, nabili na nila.
Non-recurring po. For example po, equipment, like I'm not sure, but maybe the Lung Center, bumili po sila ng maybe an X-ray machine. Pag nabili na po natin yung X-ray machine, hindi na po natin babudgetan yon for the next year because we already have the item.
Okay, so this is good. This is good that it's being explained this way. And I'm curious, the budgets that have been approved, that have come from the DBM, were these the budgets requested for 2023 by these hospitals? Or you really reviewed, you've already spent this, that's why we're giving you this? Did it go that way?
Yes, yes. Pero po, as early as March po, as early as January actually, we prepared the budget call for all the national government agencies. By March po, we asked them to submit their Tier 1. Dalawa pong klase yung pag-submission nila. Tier 1 po, ito yung mga recurring. These are the programs that binabayaran po natin yearly, like personal services or maintenance, operating expenses. Ito po yung mga recurring. And then after we submit that, we have a level for that. And then after we submit that, we'll ask them naman to submit their priority projects. Mm-hmm. That's their Tier 2 po. So it actually takes some time po. Parang may small consultation and Senate hearing po kami sa aming departamento at sa mga agencies po. They have to really explain their projects and program, if it's really implementable, if it's really needed, ganun po.
What is the most difficult in crafting this budget? I mean, coming from the executive and of course wanting this administration with 31 million votes to be able to deliver on services, right? What is the most difficult?
I think really it's the limited fiscal space that we have, no? But I expect, Paul, that in the coming years, as we try to open up our economy, we'll have more revenues. And then the economic managers are also pushing for PPP. So we will also ask the private sector to also help us. But in the end, Paul, we will try at least our best to really invest on our social expenditures, on human capital development and infrastructure.
Now, some have raised alarm just on how much we are spending for debt servicing with a budget, but Congresswoman Stella Kimbo clarified that with a 5.26 trillion budget, only 500 billion, tama? Is going to be used for debt payment, no?
So yes, I think only 11% of the budget is for the debt payments.
Only
all the rest po will...
Tama. So let's talk about that. I think this is for our viewers. There's a 1 trillion that's set aside for debt servicing, which is out of the 5.26 trillion. Tama ito, Secretary?
Yes, ma'am. Automatic po siya.
At saan nanggagaling po yun? Yung 1 trillion na nakahiwalay po doon sa 5.26 trillion na GAA?
Sa pondo rin po natin, because our funds po is fungible po in nature po, no? So pag pumasok po yan, parang bangko po, no? Pag pumasok po yan is yun po yung pondo rin po na gagamitin natin.
Mm-mm. Okay, so there's 1 trillion set aside already for debt servicing from the GAA, 500 billion. So that's 1.5 trillion to be paid for debt servicing with interest, right, for the year. Now, sinabi niyo po, I believe in an interview, is our revenues this year will be, did you say something like 3 billion, tama ba, or 2 point something billion?
Yeah, I think more or less po.
Okay. And where will we get the rest that we need? We will be borrowing from where? So how much will we be borrowing this year to fund the budget?
I'll have to get the numbers, but the
Oo.
borrowings po are mostly as what presented po by our Secretary of Finance, mostly domestic po para
Uh-oh,
wala tayong
domestic
masyadong
borrowings.
external shocks, especially with what's happening now with our foreign exchange.
Okay. And I know ideally it's the finance secretary you should be answering this, but there's been some concern with the debt to GDP ratio, secretary, for 2023. Where would we be?
We have a medium-term fiscal framework, Ms. Karen, that was passed by both by the Congress. This was presented by the President during his SONA. And then this is our plan, our economic plan po. Siguro kaya din po our budget is really quite small because we want to follow that medium-term fiscal framework. We want to put back our numbers, at least our macroeconomic numbers, to pre-pandemic levels.
Which is, tell me the goal.
The goal po is the deficit is it reached up to 7%, but we want it back to 3%.
Wow.
The debt po which reached to about 60-70%, we want it back to at least 40% po before the end of the term of the president.
And I know that during the SONA, the president outlined the medium-term fiscal goals, and you believe that's achievable with where we're going?
Yes, po. We will try to work on it, po.
Okay.
And I think with the passage of concurrence of both Congress, I think they also believe in the medium-term fiscal framework that we presented.
All right. Now we are going to take a quick break, so we're going to have a breather. But when we return, we'll continue about two of the very important agencies. We're going to talk about agriculture, Secretary, the vision of this administration for agri, the budget that you've set aside for it, the increases on that, and also the Department of Public Works and Highways. Head Start, we'll be right back. Stay with us.
Tinesting, sinuri, siniyasan. Ang resulta? Super effective ang Shield sa pagpatay ng bakterya at virus. Shield Antibacterial Soap, believe ang mga eksperto sa Philippine Nurses Association. At si Mami,
iwala ako sa Shield.
Shield Antibacterial Soap, napatunayang mabisa. Ang mga nurse, tiwala.
ACS.
Hello, Washi! Laundry day na naman!
Yay! Anong meron?
Mancha ng chocolate, putik, may libag pa!
Kaya natin yan! With Pride Washing Machine Detergent, may triple stain-away formula. Tanggal ang makapit, madikit, at malupit na dumit mancha. Kaya easy-easy ang labada.
Mula noon, hanggang ngayon!
All you need is Pride! All you need is Pride!
ACS! Boom, papaya, white rose papaya, yeah, 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 yeah. Boom, putika, in 7 days, oh yeah, 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 yeah. White rose papaya.
White rose papaya. Na may double whitening, papaya extracts plus whitening ng vitamin B3. Clinically proven magpaputi in as early as 7 days.
Boom, putika, white rose papaya.
Papaya puti, papaya fast. White rose papaya.
ACS.
Tinesting, sinuri, siniyasan. Ang resulta? Super effective ang Shield sa pagpatay ng bakterya at virus. Shield Antibacterial Soap, believe ang mga eksperto sa Philippine Nurses Association. At si Mami,
iwala ako sa Shield.
Shield Antibacterial Soap, napatunayang mabisa. Ang mga nurse, tiwala.
ACS.
Hello, Washi! Laundry day na naman!
Yay! Anong meron?
Mancha ng chocolate, putik, may libag pa!
Kaya natin yan!
With Pride Washing Machine Detergent, may triple stain-away formula. Tanggal ang makapit, madikit, at malupit na dumit mancha. Kaya easy-easy ang labada.
Mula noon, hanggang ngayon!
All you need is Pride! All you need is Pride!
ACS!
Boom! Papaya! White rose papaya! Yeah, 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 yeah! Boom! Putika! In 7 days, oh yeah, 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 yeah!
White Rose Papaya na may double whitening, papaya extracts plus whitening ng vitamin B3. Clinically proven magpaputi in as early as 7 days.
Puti ka, White Rose Papaya.
Papaya puti, papaya fast. White Rose Papaya.
PCS.
All right, welcome back to Head Start. Still with us, we have Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman. The only I'd like to repeat, because this is for women out there, we need more women in government. The only woman in the economic team and the only Muslim in the cabinet, which we've always said there should be more. Right? Okay, let's move now to agriculture. This is the president's. I would have to say this is this is the pillar of his leadership, taking the helm of the Agri Department. You have lawmakers asking the House Committee on Appropriations to provide even an additional $500 million to the Department of Agri's 2023 budget. But let's be fair and talk about the overall improvement of the agriculture budget, Secretary.
The budget of agriculture, it's one of the increases that we proposed in 2023. It actually increased to 39.2% from 2022 level. Basically, part of our 8-point socioeconomic agenda, Ms. Karen, is to have food security and affordable food in our table po.
Okay. And the increase of the 39.2%, I'm curious. So the budget in total that was submitted is how much now? Because I remember 2022, tama po ba ang DA, if my memory serves me right, was something like 90 billion?
Yes po, I'll have to check the final number po. But the total increase, but the total agriculture budget is 184.1 billion.
I'm sorry, can you repeat, ma'am?
The total agriculture budget for 2023 is 184.1 billion.
184.1 billion. So isn't that at least close to double? Or yung 90 billion nung 2022 na dagdagan ng supplemental budget, kaya ang calculation yun lang po 39?
Nadagdagan po siya dahil 39.2% po.
Oo, ang nadagdag.
2022, opo. But the total budget po is 184 billion po.
Okay. All right. And the 184 billion, where is the focus on this? I know that I wanted to ask you, some are asking for more funding for Kadiwa. I know that the president at one point was open to returning Masagana. Nandun po ba ito? Naka-line item po ba ito sa budget ng DA?
Yes po. The DA po, they have major programs since inception po. No? What we have is that National Rice Program.
Okay.
Under the proposed budget, it's 30.55 billion. It will be used to increase rice production and expansion of fertilizer support po for our farmers.
Uh-oh.
We also have the National Corn Program with 5.22 billion po for the increase in corn and cassava production. We have the National Livestock Program, the National Fisheries Program, and the National High Value Crops Development Program. Lahat
okay.
po ito nag-increase po ng budget natin.
Uh-oh.
And then beyond that po, we also included po in that budget is the budget for our irrigation, which is also equally important in our agriculture production, as well as post-harvest facilities po, and even farm-to-market roads po. It's
okay.
also included in our budget.
Pero for transparency purposes, itong 184 billion for 2023, may unprogrammed po ba dito or lahat po ito ay may pondo na talaga?
Lahat po to ay program po.
Ayun. Okay, everything is program. Let's move now to the DPWH, okay? Let's talk about that. There's an alleged 544 billion peso lump sum appropriation in the DPWH, which, as I mentioned, a while ago, Senator Coco Pimentel flagged it and said this is potential pork because it lacks details, no line item, it lacks transparency. Ano po ba ang nakasaad sa NEP doon sa 544 billion na yon?
When we prepared the NEP po, we have a level po per agency. And then per agency po, like DPWH po, there are defined programs that they have to consider po, like kung paano po reconstruction, rehabilitation, maintenance. Mm-mm. Meron po yan. Actually, hindi ko po alam kung saan po nang galing yung lump sum fund. Maybe po the lump sum fund is in the form of right of way. Kasi po yung mga gastos po nila na on right of way, which I know po, is wala pa po yata tong specific details because it will depend po pag in-implement na nila yung mga projects. Oh, but oh. I know that the projects under DPWH is in details po. Kasi po usually po makapal po yan. So siguro po yung iba po ay meron po din kasi tayong tinatawag na errata sa ating budget. Minsan po kasi, like yung DPWH, given also the transition po, no, they were not siguro able to give all the details of their project, maybe per district or per town or per province or per municipality. So we also give them time at least to prepare that and then submit to us and then we submit it to Congress po.
Oo. Okay, pero parang baliktad, no? Kasi if you were gonna do the budget, tumingi ka ng pera, dapat nakasulat na yung kailangan mo. Are you saying that often agencies sometimes will ask for a specific budget pero yung detalye nun sa huli na?
Hindi po. Hindi okay. po. May detalye po yan. May specific programs po, especially for DPWH because we have to consider po that DPWH talagang major programs po siya.
Yeah.
Talagang most of it, for example, if they have supply po, 30% will really go to reconstruction, 40% will go to maintenance. So maybe I know that they have a formula po on how to allocate these funds. Mm-hmm. Per district, per area po, or Uh-oh. Even, I think, barangay.
So when Senator Pimentel said that the unspecified allotments of DPWH were 75%, and this is his quote, of DPWH's proposed 718 billion peso budget, is this accurate?
I think it was already explained po by DPWH that Uh-oh. They have the details for this. So, mm-hmm. hindi po siya lump sum.
Okay. All right. Now, the mantra of the last administration was build, build, build. I remember interviewing then Budget Secretary Ben Diokno during President Duterte's time, and his goal was an ambitious spending, I think more than 6% of GDP on infra because China was at 12%. This was an old discussion we've had on Head Start. Where are we in terms of spending for infra in relation to GDP?
We're very consistent po from the very beginning. Even the president po during his SONA informed that we will continue the build, build, build projects of the previous administration. Pero bago na po ang anyo niya, we will call it BBM, Build Better More.
BBM na, Build Better More.
BBM na po, Build okay. Better More. And well, with our MTFF po, it's also there that the infrastructure spending po of the Marcos Jr. administration will increase from 5% po this year up to 6.2% until 2028 po.
Uh-oh.
So we will still pursue po yung build and build better more program po of the previous administration.
Okay. Well, I know that you're with a budget, but in your meetings, are you able to discuss what would be how you would improve build, build, build? Because I know that in the beginning, if my memory serves me right, I think that tama ba ito, ma'am, the Duterte administration released more than 718 priority projects for build, build, build. Tama ba yon?
I think yes.
Parang eh, no? Kasi,
parang
pero ito po sa Build Better More under President Marcos Jr., is it paramihan ba ng proyekto or palakihan ba? Ano po? Ilan ang bilang ng kanyang infra priority projects?
When we assume po this administration, I know that there are 99 infrastructure projects na meron po tayo sa NEDA that are readily implementable. Okay. Of course, yung 700 po, I think that's the pie of the entire projects that we want to pursue for at least siguro given administration. But what's nice now is that we have the almost 100 readily implementable projects between DPWH and DOTR po. So and of course there's also kasama din po dito yung mga projects natin under DAT po. Ito yung mga malalaking mga I think ports to improve our logistics.
Okay, all right. Now, I know you have a meeting, so I could speak to you for one more hour, but I know you're rushing off. You have a hearing, no? Tama ito, Secretary. You have a hearing.
Nakaspot ako sa Senate.
Yun nga eh. So I really want to thank you already for giving me time on Head Start. So I think my last question for you is, I think being appointed as Budget Secretary right now, and I mean some people, you're quite young. You're probably one of the youngest budget secretaries I've interviewed in my history in the news. Is what do you believe is your biggest hurdle as budget secretary, and what is your personal goal that you'd want to achieve as budget secretary?
The hurdle really is that the budget is really we are on a tight fiscal space because of what's happening with external shocks, not just the pandemic, but what's happening in the war and all of the external shocks, no. So I think that's one of the issues that we have really to face. But we will try to allocate funds for our priority programs and projects. And maybe if I may po, I really wanted really to push for digitalization po in our bureaucracy.
Oh, very interesting. That's your personal advocacy, no?
Yes po, kasi when that happened po when we were in Banco Central ng Pilipinas, in BSP po, together with then Governor Jokno po. One of the advocacies po there is yung financial inclusion, and much of it is really on digital payments po. I think if we will digitalize all the systems, processes in government, malaki po ang pera po na pwede nating ma-save dyan. And with that savings po, at least we'll have a chance to allocate more funding for the most pressing projects and programs that we need po.
All right. On that note, Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman, thank you for joining me today and good luck in the Senate.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right. More success to you. Thank you.
Salamat po.